Welcome, welcome to my messy desk. Just ignore what's around my cutting mat. I thought I was going to show you, maybe not this one, this is not too exciting. I wanted to show you what I got from my friend who's been cleaning out the house of the older gentleman she was taking care of, who passed away. And I got to dig through the attic today, and she had already found all these things and saved them, put them in a safe spot for me, because the family was just gonna throw it out because they said they don't know the people and they don't want to deal with it. So I have three very old scrapbooks, and they're a treasure, especially this one. None of the photos in this one, look at how fat this is, like the cover, it's so cool, it's so sturdy. I think it's wood, maybe. It has, there's no dates in this, except for there are some death notifications from late 1800. Well, we'll see it, but so I guess all these photos were taken somewhere in 1800, whatever. But I had to share this because it's so much history in this thing. Okay. So, and I can get over how cool this album is. So there's a whole bunch of old photos, and these are actually the cabinet cards that I was talking about. Now I have some, but these are stuck in here. Some I can take out, but not all of them. So yeah, unfortunately I checked on some of the cards back and there's no dates, but these are all so old. Look at her. And they were all taken in Old Town, Maine. Because the photographer's name is on it, but not the date. Old Town, Maine. Can I take this one out? Yep. So these are the cabinet cards. These are cardboard with the photo on it, mounted on it. And then you would just stick those in those old albums. Her name is Anna. So here's a death notice from 1892. Just says our darling. 1891. And then there's one. Look at her dress. Isn't this a beautiful? Oops, sorry for the glare. Beautiful dress. Most of them I cannot even get out. There was one death notice hidden behind a photo, and it was from a four-year-old. That made me very sad. I know way back when it was children often died early because of health issues. Get this is beautiful. Julie. I just wish there was some dates on him. Oh yeah, here. Israel English from 1891. Aged 4 years. That makes me so sad. Is there something on the back? Whoa! There's stuff hidden. Oh, it's from the photographer, I guess. Huh. Yeah, so but I didn't see any kids like kids in here that had that name, so yeah, there's no photos. I don't know, if this was from my family I wouldn't want to throw it away, even if I didn't know the people, but I don't know. Yeah, and then there's a mother with her children. Take this out. Oh no, never mind. So what we just saw on the other side is the back of, it was the back of this one. And some little kid. Wow. that's like a piece of metal. Wow. These are old. I didn't know they did photos like this. Wow. Fascinating. Yeah, so I will treasure this because some people just throw this away. And then there's a bunch of calling cards. Aren't these cool? A little fragile, but pretty. Oh, this one is missing. And what are you? Oh, it's from 1880. It's like a something about the saint. The family was Catholic. So yeah, this was the oldest one. And then this one, let me take this out because I don't know what this is all about. Miami Beach is full of these beautiful old postcards, and I think they're all, nope, some of them were have been written and mailed. And I love these photo corners because they're like the airmail colors and this super old paper. Are these just stunning? All Miami. Oh, Florida, yep. So cool. This must be a wonderful place to visit. It's quite far from here though, okay? Wherever you were. And we have some Colorado. Wow. And that's, nope. I thought I saw Pike's Peak. Oh wow, nice fishing. Oh, that's Pike's Peak. And then there's some black and white postcards. Kansas City. Oh, I just love those. Georgia School of Technology. They have such nice colors. Oh, that's the same one as in the beginning. Anyway, so that's the scrapbook full of postcards, and it's made from wood. Oops. And I'm dropping postcards. And then this big thing is full of old greeting cards. There's a lot of Easter cards. They were Catholic, like I mentioned. And so they had like lots of Catholic cards, but there's some really nice ones in here. They had like these weird little tapes. Isn't this cute? Greetings, here I come, wishing you Easter happiness, and then some. He is risen. Oh, to someone indoors. Hope you're feeling better, and here's a cheery thought to brighten up your day and show that I forget you not. Oh, because it's forget-me-nots. Oh, that's adorable. I also love this one. It has the gold. Look at this. I haven't had a chance to look at all of them yet. Because I was busy with my daughter since I got home. Hurry, get well. Oh, I think these are all just precious. Oh, this is a 3D one. Look at that. So neat. Oh, hope you'll soon be well. I gotta write down those sayings they have in them, because they're cute and they rhyme. Thinking of you. Oh, perfect. A special little Valentine with thoughts of you in every line, just meant to sort of let you see how very much you mean to me. Oh, yesterday was Valentine's Day. So yeah, precious cards. And wow, there's no end. Wow, lots of get well cards. Someone was ill or very popular and everybody sent a get well card. Just can't bear to have you sick. Aww. Cute. Oh, what are you? Oh, wow. Secret. Wow, it's... Who? What in the world is this? monthly record. Grade. Oh my gosh! It's the school records. Grade 8, grade 7, and grade 9. I was like, what is this? From 1941. So if grade 7 was 1940, and grade 9, so I guess 41, 40, and 39. Oh my gosh, I've never seen this, like a record card like this before. Deportment, application, Christian doctrine, reading, grammar, spelling, arithmetic, algebra, Latin, geography, history, civics, lecture, grammar, appellation, average, days absent. Oh, she had no days absent. Time tardy. No tardiness. Oh. Here she was absent for 12 and a half days. 13 and a half days. Someone was ill. Maybe that's why we have all the get well cards. Wow. Okay. You never know what... Wow. This looks cool. Shine. You never know what you find. Oh my gosh. I wonder if that's why maybe... Alex. Oh, maybe that's why she had all these get well cards. And envelopes. Where are the envelopes? Oh, a little doily with holes in them. What's in here? Now I'm curious. Probably nothing. I don't think there's anything in there. Okay, so just wanted to share this with you guys because I went treasure hunting. And I cannot believe all the things I found. Yeah. Oh, this is cool. This is like pieces. Sweet. I've always only seen things like this. Oh yeah, there's some creepy old dude. like in YouTube videos or like photos on Pinterest or whatever. And now I can actually hold this in my own hands. Oh, now I just saw this beautiful pattern. There's like scissors on here and a book. So beautiful. I wish I knew who this belonged to. Oh yeah, probably the girl that had the grade cards in here. Let's see. I want to find out if that was the mother of the old gentleman. Oh, here we go. Her name was Teresa Pelletier. No, can be, because if the gentleman was in his 90s, maybe it was his wife. I don't know. Promoted to grade 10. Promoted to grade 8. Promoted to grade 9. So cool. Yep, nice memories, I guess. Or not, they're not my memories, but history. So... I hope you find it as interesting as I find it, and if not, next video will be crafty again. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I hope you're all doing well. Bye!